I love getting ASUS motherboards for review because they're beautiful both inside and out. I mean, take a look at this X670E-E gaming Wi-Fi. 18 plus 2 power faces, 8-layer PCB, 8 layers, 1 PCIe 5 GPU slot, 2 PCIe 5 NVMe slots, and it looks so good in black. Or this ROG Strix B650-A gaming Wi-Fi. Hard to go wrong. Because they're beautiful both in with this kind of color scheme, white and gray, 1 PCIe 5 NVMe slot, and really just the attention to detail. Siguro mga 1% lang of users will actually bother to flip the board around and look at the back. Kasi likod nga to, walang titingin dito. But even then, ASUS said, what the heck, we're gonna make it pretty, we're gonna put our design on it, and it, you know, that whole attention to detail and quality, just superb. But I also hate reviewing motherboards because they're so hard to talk about. What makes them interesting is very technical. Like, ano ba yung significance na more number of power faces better? So what kung 8 layers yung PCB? Bakit may dalawang E sa X670E-E? Oo, may significance yun. So we'll do something a bit different. Yes, we'll still throw the technical terms at you kasi apparently gusto ninyo yun. But we'll also slow down and take the time to actually explain ano ba tong numbers and acronyms, what do they all mean? Kasi alam mo naman tayo sa channel na to, we take the hard out of hardware. You know what I mean. Pinaka-basic muna tayo, there are currently two chipsets which support AMD 7000 series. Ito yung X670 and B650. But both of these chipsets have extreme versions. Ito yung unang E sa ROG X670E-E gaming Wi-Fi. So there's the X670E, X670, B650E, and then B650. Yung isa pang mobo in this video, the ROG B650-A gaming Wi-Fi, is the standard version of the B650. Hindi siya extreme. Nakakalito sa simula, pero madaling tandaan yung pagkaiba nila since the difference is just in how much PCIe 5 goodness each board has. Higher number better, the more PCIe lanes, the faster the CPU can communicate with all of the other parts. So yung X670E has 24 usable lanes of PCIe 5. X670 has 8 lanes, B650E has 24 lanes, and you heard that right. It has the same number of lanes as the X670E. Tapos, yung pinaka basic version, B650, walang PCIe 5 lanes at all. Also, only the extreme versions have PCIe 5 on the PCIe expansion slots, aka where you plug your GPU in. All versions though support PCIe 5 NVMe slots, although for the B650, that depends on the board manufacturer. In this case, the ROG B650-A gaming Wi-Fi does have a PCIe 5 NVMe slot. So those are the basics in general. Dive in tayo sa specifics nitong dalawang boards na to. And we'll start with the Q goodness of ASUS, the Q release and the Q latch. Both of these boards have those features. For ASUS boards, I like starting with the Q features because they're so useful. Really clever touches from ASUS. The Q latch is for SSDs, which does away with the M.2 screw, which is annoyingly small and easily lost, and actually quite difficult to install too. The Q release allows you to remotely unlock the PCIe slot, which is a godsend when dealing with large cards and you can't fit your fingers beneath the card to unlock the clip. Parang maliit lang na mabagay yung mga to, but if you're an enthusiast or you build a lot of computers, you recognize how bloody useful these two features are. Other brands should just blatantly rip this stuff off and so it becomes an industry standard. Sorry ASUS, pero imitation is the serious form of flattery nga naman, diba? Onto power faces, the X670E-E is a beast with 18 plus 2 power faces. I think this board has the most number of power faces that I've ever physically interacted with. The first number, 18, are the number of power faces dedicated to the CPU, and the second number, 2, are the number of power faces dedicated to everything else on the motherboard. 18 plus 2 is an extremely high number, even for high-end motherboards. You want more power faces because the more faces you have, the more tightly you can control the voltage, the electricity running into the different components. The CPU in particular needs just a very finely tuned range of electricity, and it has to be clean electricity. It can't have a lot of spikes. So the more power faces you have, the more finely tuned the electricity is, and the cleaner it is signal-wise. Both crucial things to CPU health as well as CPU overclocking. The B650-A gaming Wi-Fi is no slouch with 12 plus 2 power stages. 12 plus 2 is actually a very respectable number. It's in keeping with a mid-range motherboard. In contrast, the Z790-A, which we took a look at a month ago, also from ASUS, has 15 plus 1. And the Z790 is the highest possible chipset for Intel's latest 13th gen. So 15 plus 1 is already quite high end. And then comparing that to what we have here, 18 plus 2 for the X670E-E and 12 plus 2 for the B650-A. You can really see, especially in the X670E, na grabe talaga. I mean, Ryzen 7000 does use a lot of power, so you do want those extra power faces again, just to more finely tune the voltage being pumped into your CPU. 18 plus 2 is crazy. I mean, again, cannot emphasize just how crazy it is for me that we actually have a board in use with those number of power faces. 12 plus 2 is decent. Again, that's more in keeping with a mid-range board. Moving on to another proxy number for quality, our number of PCB layers. And the X670E is again bonkers with 8 PCB layers. Rule of thumb, usually entry-level boards are 4, mid to high-end boards are 6 layers, and the extreme motherboards are 8. I've never seen an 8-layer PCB board at this price range, to be honest. Yes, the X670E is a bit pricey, we'll get to that in a bit. But usually, an 8-layer board has a much higher price than this. You want more layers because that gives the designers more room to work with. More room to make proper connections between the different components, more room to stabilize and isolate problematic parts in the sense that there's a lot of energy that's going to be coursing through this. We don't want it affecting the stability of the other parts, interacting, affecting other parts, so we're going to shunt it off to one side. The more layers you have, just give the designers more freedom to have more stable connections, basically to come up with a more quality board. This isn't always the case. I mean, more space just means that you can be a bit sloppier. You can have 6-layer boards or even 4-layer boards that are just as good, but it takes a lot more effort to design them to be as good. 8 layers is just really an extreme amount. Although considering the number of PCIe 5 connections of X670E has and the amount of voltage it needs to take in for the enthusiast level 7000 CPUs that most likely people would pair with it, perhaps that's why they went with 8 layers. The other mobile, the ROG B650-A gaming Wi-Fi, is no slouch with 6 layers. For M.2 slots, the X670E has 4, 2 PCIe 5, and 2 PCIe 4. The B650-A has 3, 1 PCIe 5, and 2 PCIe 4. Max speed of RAM compatibility, both top out at 6400 MHz. This is a very decent number for DDR5 RAM, in keeping with the high-end range of what you could reasonably buy nowadays. For internet speed, both again have the same spec, Wi-Fi 6E and a 2.5GB Ethernet port. For most mid-range boards and up nowadays, I don't really look at the possible maximum internet speed anymore because dito sa atin, mas likely na yung bottleneck or yung mas mabagal na component yung internet connection mo rather than what the motherboard can take in. So, you know, Wi-Fi 6E, 2.5GB, all nice to have, nice to brag about. But realistically, anong ISP dito sa atin, kanino ka makakakuha ng speed na ganyan? Or kahit speed na medyo malapit pa dun. Moving on to the nice to have extras, these are just the little things that make working with the board just a little bit easier. The X670E does have a clear CMOS button. The B650-A does not. Both have a BIOS flashback feature, really useful if you want to update the BIOS. And it's nice that even the B650-A has that feature. For diagnostic lights, the B650-A does have these. Pretty standard in most motherboards, mid-range and up. Standard for high-end motherboards is what you find on the X670E, which has a digital error readout. Basically, it'll spit out a number, and then you need to go look up what that number means when it encounters an error. So nothing too out of the ordinary for the nice-to-have stuff. Before we get to the price, let me just say that both boards handled superbly in our tests, easily delivering the speeds of RAM and CPU that were advertised without any problems. Our heat testing of VRMs is not the most accurate yet, we're still working on that, but from the rough tests we did, temps on both were pretty good, especially considering that the raw electricity usually consumed by 7000 CPUs. Before again we get to the price, just as a side note, both boards look gorgeous with so many little details that have no practical value really, but show that motherboards don't need to look so damn boring. And that the ASUS designers are geeks, much like their core consumer. Personally, I really appreciate these little flourishes. So nice to look at and a wittier expression of aesthetic compared to just slapping some RGB on a product and calling it a day. Onto the price, the X670E retails for around $500, or it should, that's the MSRP, with the B650-A almost half that at just around $280. A lot of ink has been spilled complaining just how expensive the 7000 ecosystem is, and a lot of the blame with the CPUs expensive and the motherboards themselves expensive. Even the B650-A price is already a high-end board in other ecosystems. And yet here on the Ryzen 7000, it's just kind of mid-range. It's not even the B650-E. But it is what it is. These are the options available. If you're looking to get into the Ryzen 7000, the ROG Strix B650-A Gaming Wi-Fi is a good choice. And to be honest, you don't need a lot of the PCIe 5 goodness now. Yes, the B650-A doesn't have a PCIe slot. So what? Even the 4090 now isn't a PCIe 5 card. The B650-A does have a PCIe 5 NVMe slot. But again, so what? PCIe 5 NVMEs have been announced, but good luck finding them right now in the wild. So even the entry level, which is what the B650-A is, kind of like the entry-level board for Ryzen 7000, it's more geared towards the future. You can't really appreciate the speed boosts it has yet. You might want to just go with the B650-A, since even at that level, the speed boost is still mostly potential. You can't actually buy hardware yet that will take advantage of it. So why splurge for an expensive board if even at the entry level, you're not already maximizing the hardware? I mean, the ROG X670E-E is just amazing, man. 18 plus 2 power faces, 8-layer PCB board. I mean, come on. And sometimes when I say these kind of things, I do run into trouble with some comments saying that I'm not being realistic enough and not being mindful of other people's budgets. And it's true, $500 MSRP, probably more expensive pa dito sa atin, is quite a lot for a board. CPU na yan, GPU na yan. Pero dito sa Ryzen 7000, mobo lang yan. I mean, damn. At least you can say you're getting what you paid for. Again, 18 plus 2 power faces and 8-layer level PCB are both things I would not thought I would see at this price range. So for score, we're gonna give the X670E 4.5 candies. A bit on the pricey side, but you really do get what you pay for. And 4 candies for the B650-A. This would basically be your entry-level board currently for the Ryzen 7000 series. It's still a bit pricey, as with most ASUS products, but it serves as a good foundation to bring you up to that PCIe 5 goodness when that hardware does get released. Bit hard really to justify doubling up your ante and shifting to the X670E. So for a lot of people, the ROG B650-A would be the responsible, sane choice. But if you're feeling a bit insane, I have to say that X670E-E gaming Wi-Fi is just superb. Thanks for watching.
Paminsan, may nagtatanong kung may kilala ba kaming computer shop na trusted, yung hindi ka lolokohin. Actually, meron kami. Full-service PC store ang Hardware Sugar. Nagbabenta kami ng PC components. Nagbabenta rin kami ng fully assembled rigs. We clean computers. Kasama na rin yung excellent cable management namin and CPU cooler repasting sa cleaning. We also clean and repaste GPUs. Nasa Makati yung physical store namin and you can also buy from our site www.hwsugar.ph na 100% palaging up-to-date yung inventory dun. Kung in-stock yung item sa amin, available yun sa site. We also ship nationwide. Thanks for watching and maybe one of these days, magkita tayo sa shop.
I love getting... Sorry. I love getting Asus motherboards. Or this ROG Strix B650-A gaming Wi-Fi. Ugh.